Now, I'm going to explain about the internal structure of the heart. This is 10th class of the topic. Internal structure of the heart. Heart is, this is heart. These are parts of the heart. Heart is pear-shaped structure. Pear and one or the other type of the fruit. That is the shape. This is type. This is pear-shaped structure and triangle in outer line. This is outer line. What is the shape? Triangular. Triangle. Look like triangle. The outer line. Look at the outline. Triangle. Outline looking triangle. This wider at the anterior end. This is anterior part. This is posterior part. Here, anterior part. In this anterior part, wider at the anterior part. This type part are wider. Wider at the anterior part. Posterior at the narrow part. In posterior part, narrow. In here, wider at the anterior, narrow at the posterior end. Here, posterior end, very narrow. Narrower at the posterior end. Wider at the anterior end. Anterior parts, posterior parts. Anterior means upside, downside is posterior parts. Here, the heart is covered by two layers of membrane. This heart is covered by two layers of membrane. That membrane is called pericardial membrane. Pericardial membrane. Pericardial membrane. The heart is covered by two layers of membrane. The membrane is called pericardial membrane. There is a space between two layers. The space is filled with the fluid. That fluid is called pericardial fluid. What is the function of pericardial fluid? Means this pericardial fluid protect the heart from shocks. If anyone get any shock, the heart is protect the heart from shocks. This is the function of pericardial fluid. This is the function. Next, the heart is divided into four chambers by grooves in it. By grooves in it, heart is divided into four chambers. One, two. This is four chambers here. Outside, this is right atrium, this is one chamber. This is left atrium, this is one chamber. And next chamber is, this is right ventricle, this is left ventricle. These are four chambers. Next, here, this heart is walls are contains coronary vessels. Coronary vessels. These vessels protect the heart. This coronary vessels supply the blood to the muscles of the heart. This coronary vessels supply the blood to the muscles of the heart. These heart walls contain coronary vessels. The coronary vessels supply the blood to the muscles of the heart. Next, the ventricles. The ventricles, these type chambers, walls are very thicker. These ventricles, these two chambers walls very thicker than atriums. These ventricles walls are thicker than atriums. Next, this right atrium right ventricles are bigger than left atrium ventricle when compared to these ones. Here, these two are bigger there. These two atrium and ventricle. Right atrium, right ventricle bigger than left atrium, left ventricle. When we compare these two. Next, here two types of ventricles there. Or the two ventricles are. First one, that is it, ventricles are arterioles. Less rigid vessels called veins. Veins. These are two types. This is first one, rigid blood vessels, arterioles. Less addresses. Rigid blood vessels arterias, less rigid blood vessels are veins. Now I'm going to explain what is the function of arterias and veins. The function as the function of the arterias is this supply originate from the heart. This arterias originate from the heart, supply the blood to all body of the plants, all body of the parts of the all body parts of the heart, plants or body. Arterias are supply the arterias are supply blood to all parts of the body. Next, veins collect the blood all parts collect the blood from all parts of the body. First arterias are originate from the heart and supply blood to all body parts of the all body parts. Veins are collect the blood from the all body parts. Here the arterias here the biggest arterias is aorta. Smallest arteries are pulmonary artery. Here aorta, this is the biggest arterias. This is the smallest arterias. This pulmonary artery supplies blood to the lungs. This arterias are supply blood to all body parts. Next, this pulmonary artery function is supply the blood to the lungs. This is the function of the pulmonary artery. This is the smallest artery. Next, here veins. Veins are two types. So superior vena cava and inferior. Superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. This is right. We can find this right side of the heart. And right side of the heart and posterior part. Here this is superior vena cava. This collect the blood from head and arms. This collect the blood. Next, inferior vena cava. This inferior vena cava collect the blood from anterior part, posterior part of the body. This is posterior part. This is anterior part of the body. This is inferior vena cava collect the blood from the anterior part of the body. Anterior part of the body means legs and hands. This is posterior part. This is anterior part. This superior vena cava collect the blood from posterior part. Like the head. This inferior vena cava is collect the blood from anterior parts of the body. For example, hands, legs. Here. Next, there is a septa between a muscle. Separate the two atriums and atrium ventricles. There is a septa, and the septa is separated the atrium ventricles. There is a septa. Here we can see septa between atricles and ventricles. Next, we can hear the openings of the there is openings between artery and ventricles. There is openings of artery and ventricles. There is a guarded, that openings are guarded by walls. Here, tricuspid wall.